Ladies and gentlemen, this is it, our main event of the evening. This is for the Pro Wrestling Malta Heavyweight Championship. And as the number one contender makes his way towards the battlefield, he is thinking to himself, can I do it? Will I do it? And I believe 100% that he is truly on his way to earning that crown jewel, because he's none other than the magician himself from the fifth dimension. His name is Jeff Quinn. And now, to be a bit more realistic, I believe he actually will do it, simply because I see it clearly as day. He has the champion's number. He has outperformed him in numerous occasions, to be honest, to the point where the champion, Roddy, was a bit envious. Have you seen previously when these two met? Roddy blindsided Jeff Quinn, and honestly, Roddy hasn't actually stated a valid reason as to why he did it. Could be jealousy, could be the fact that he knows his time could be up. And it could be up in just a few short moments, because this battle can go either way. It can go 5 minutes, it can go 5 seconds. It can. Jeff Quinn is going to do whatever it takes to get the job done and get it done quick. And believe me when I tell you, he has a lot of tricks up his sleeves to make that a possibility. Here he is, the so-called proud Pro Wrestling Malta champion. Well, let's be honest, I'm going to be very honest, I'm going to be a freaking biased commentator here, because I was proud of Roddy, to be honest. I actually was. This guy used to be the pinnacle of what it means to be a warrior here at Pro Wrestling Malta. And yeah, he still is formidable. That's why henceforth he's still the champion, but I'm talking about the warrior within. He has lost that spirit, he has lost that vulnerability, he has lost so much respect from these people that at this point, you might as well call him a vacant champion, just a body without a soul. But at the end of the day, technicalities or not, he is still the champion here in Malta. But for how long? That is the question that will be answered right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, the challenge.
I think you need to pull out a poll to see who the audience is behind in this match. Physically glamorous, at least in his eyes, but in front of the people, he is nothing but dirt, he is nothing but coal. And speaking of that, Merry Christmas to everybody around the world now. We know that Roddy's been a bit naughty this year, but hey, let's see if he's gonna end up leaving tonight with the cold or with nothing but a lump of coal. Heck, you know what, he might even deserve that coal, he might just end up with nothing. Already, Roddy, I don't know if Roddy is trying to engage with the fans, his former fans, I should say, trying to, you know, save face, but at the same time, you know, the people have made up their mind, and he shouldn't focus on them right now, he should focus on the one person in front of him, the challenger, Jeff Quinn. It called him nothing, but that kick didn't feel like nothing. Oh, wait! It could be over in a few seconds! Oh, I was about to say. I was joking that he was actually going to finish it in 5 seconds, and I thought it was actually going to come to fruition. Oh, my God. He should never take your eyes off Jack Quinn. Well, okay. You blink, and you won't even know if he's up in the air or landing on the ground like a falcon. Roddy letting himself get frustrated over nothing right now. Nothing. Well, except a kick and a sweep. Pulling it up with a moonsault. And no, of course, the battle still goes on. And I will give Roddy this, as I've given a lot of former champions beforehand. There were a reason where they were all champions, including Roddy. The resilience factor will come to fruition. Oh, and so is the experience factor. Look at that hot shot on the top rope from Roddy. Into a back suplex. Almost like a side effect slam. And not even a two count from Roddy. Now, look at that, look at that. He's just letting his emotions take forth. Pounding the ever-living hell or magic out of the magician. And now he's setting up Quinn on the top rope, top turnbuckle. He's dangling into a tree of woe. And now he's proceeding to choke the everlasting life out of him. Not magic, the life out of him. Oxygen being forced out of the body and throat of Quinn. And a drop kick to seal the deal. Cover? No. This time he gets a two count. But he doesn't get the victory. But he's getting closer. He's getting closer. And he's cinching it in. And he knows it. Roddy, he was about to lose his grip, but immediately just retaliated with a slap. Oh, man! You heard that one! And a forearm shot and a backhand blow. Roddy back in control right there in a pit. Wait! Springboard! Oh, he was going to go for a springboard elbow! Instead, his back got springboard to oblivion with a kick. And another one at the back of the nape from Jack Quinn. Look at that now. He's sizing him up from corner to corner, post to post. Knee drop. Wait. No. The only thing dropping is Roddy's body. Two. Now Roddy's the one that's forced to kick out. Exerting energy. And Quinn. Oh, Quinn is feeling it. Kick. Oh, no. Into a neck breaker by Roddy. Roddy right now, I don't know what the hell he's doing. Go for the pin. You want the championship at least. He wasted so much time with that. He should have just went straight for the pin. It would have been a treat, Roddy. I don't know what you're complaining. You're the one that took forever to go for the cover. Come on. Now look at that. The champion antagonizing the challenger. This is a bit hard to watch, honestly, if I'm going to be frank with all of you. Roddy used to be so honorable, right? This is the way he treats Quinn. Quinn was his friend, too. Both in the locker room and in the ring. Partners on so many occasions. And now it just boils down to this. Who wants it more? Who wants the gold more? Is it the envious Roddy or the magician Jack Quinn? European uppercut. Shot after shot, blow after blow, and yeah, that one took down Quinn right towards his knees. Everybody knows he's in control, at least momentarily. As I said, momentarily, kick right into the chest. And another one follows up. Oh no for Roddy. Count kick spin right into the chest. This is it. Hold on, here it comes, run up! No! Russian leg sweep! And a kick out by Roddy. Roddy knows right now that it's do or die, and he needs to exert every ounce of energy in order to retain that championship. And Quinn needs to exert every ounce of energy from his part to claim that championship. And he might dodge do that. Quinn going for a Samoan drop. No, instead, Ronnie reverses into a spinning suplex neck breaker. What the hell was that? And instead, as a result of the fall. I don't know what you call that. Is that a curtain call? It could have been curtains for the challenger, but instead, we're still in here. The show goes on. But for how long? For how long? Jump! No! He got caught into a fireman neck breaker! No! What? Ruddy's still fighting, his heart's still beating. If he has a heart anymore, but regardless, he has the energy to still be in this bout. Quinn is going for the Shining Wizard, is he? Yes, that's it, the death nail. Do it. Quinn. He missed. Oh, no. Oh, he was going to go for the official. Drop kick. Oh, man. And the official takes a hard shot right into the sternum. Roddy is going to capitalize. No. Butterfly DDT instead. Quinn! Shining Wizard! Shining Wizard! Hello? Oh no, you gotta be kidding me. You got me, sis. Come on, official, it wasn't even that hard, man. Come on! Wake the hell up! Ruddy should have lost this bout, and Quinn should have been our champion! And look at the result. Quinn realizing that Ruddy just got back up to his feet. Wait, hold on! Butterfly DDT! Well, and the official is still down to make any call whatsoever. Ronnie's frustrated, but you know, it's a double-edged sword. He would have lost his championship if the official was up even earlier. Ronnie, oh, I thought he was going for his patented frog splash, but instead, like a frog, he's going to latch onto that championship. And he's bringing it forward. Oh no. No, 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 no. Quinn, he ducked the shot. Kick into the shin. Quinn, Shining Wizard into the back of the head. Concussing the champion. And this it. This it. Oh, come on now. Wait. What the? What the? Envy. And why, Adam? Envy just decided to cost Quinn his crowning moment. And he would have been champion too. And Quinn knows this. Quinn felt it. And now he's going to let Adam Envy get away. I guarantee he won't. But listen, the power's still on. Quinn, forget about it for now. Ronnie's right behind you. Focus on that. Let the official do his job and bend this random fancy idiot away. Oh, wait. Oh, Ronnie from the back of the head. Assaulting the contender. And dashing him right towards the ring post. Oh, you gotta be kidding. Is this how it's all going to end? No, 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 no. Yes. Yes. Quinn can still win. But now it seems like Ruddy has an ally on the outside, looking out like a twisted guardian angel. Ruddy's setting up what could be the finale. And he ducks, no wait. Ruddy was going for the Shining Wizard. And now Quinn was going for the Butterfly DDT. Duck, twist and turns. Brain Buster! Brain Buster! That's it! That's it! Oh, you come on now! Oweya! Shinless Oweya, man! Adam Henry is dragging the official once again! The official should have barred this guy! This guy should have been fined already! Quinn, look out behind you! Look out behind you! Ruddy with the belt! He just struck him with that gold bladed championship title! And no! Oh, you gotta be kidding me around here! No, come on! You've got... What did he take like that? What the... What an absolute disgraceful way to retain your championship. This is the head of Pro Wrestling Malta. If that's the case, this whole entire company is one massive giant serpent.